competition is sort of boring. We have the same pawn structure, the same pieces, the same everything. Of course, I'd rather have black because black's king is safer. You know, white's pawn really doesn't need to be on g4, but that happened earlier in the game. Okay, and I played rook to e4, attacking his queen. I'm trying to get some initiative. Queen to d3, I'm just attacking things. Rook b4, attacking the b-pawn. And my opponent played b3. Now it's really hard to attack anything. There's nothing to attack. Okay, so I played queen f6 because my queen's good on f6. I have a nice open diagonal here. And it's not a nice file. And maybe if he lets me, I'll get to play queen f3 and checkmate him. Although that's never going to happen, unfortunately. Okay, and my opponent was in the trade mode. And this is a problem that I have with a lot of my private students. They want to trade every move, and I'm like, never trade. And my opponent's lower rated than me. He's in the 2200s, and he likes to draw against me if he gets the chance. So he's like, trade, 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 draw. And I don't really blame him. I think his next move is very reasonable, bishop to g2. If he trades everything off, how am I going to win? And I played the move rook d8 because I'm keeping in line with my theme, always attack everything. So the first move I attacked is queen. The second move I attacked is b-pawn. This is the fourth move, and I attacked his queen. If you attack your opponent's pieces every move, well, maybe they'll blunder. And this is a really funny, this was in a Spice Cup that was played in St. Louis. And I remember very specifically what happened at this point. So when this position started, four moves ago, I had already foreseen that white could do something like this and blunder, and I was hoping that he would, but probably he wouldn't, and then he did. And he blundered with the move queen c3. I mean, the official title obviously is overworked, but we're talking about a very specific overworked and overloaded. When the rook is defending the queen, and the rook is defending the back rank, and obviously it's hard for a rook to move in two different directions at once. And I've seen this trick many times in my career, especially in other people's games. And the next one I'm going to show you is much more difficult, but it's the same idea. Here I played the move rook d1 check. And again, when you get to play a move like this, it's cool. If you're doing tactics trainer on chess.com, you're going to see things like this all the time. Well, the obvious idea is if he takes my rook, I'll take his queen because his rook is defending his queen. And so my opponent didn't do that. He hoped beyond hope that he could escape by playing the move king h2. And in fact, this is still a normal idea when you play this rook to the back rank check is now you trade queens, queen takes c3, and now my opponent resigned because after rook takes c3, I win his rook in the corner, and I'm up a rook. So let's go back to the blunder. In this position, if he moves his queen anywhere safe, I don't know, e2, g3, e3, position's close to equal. I'd rather have black, but it's, I mean, it should be a draw. And queen c3, there's no reason for such a move. He just wants to trade everything. But queen c3 is risky because when pieces can capture each other, that's very dangerous for everybody. That has potential of winning and losing material. If you move his queen to a safe square where nobody can capture anything, that's not dangerous at all. And of course, he didn't see rook d1. He probably knew the idea, but he sort of lost his sense of danger because all the pieces look like they're going to be traded. And chess always is dangerous. There's always tactical tricks. And luckily for me, he played the one I was hoping he would. And unfortunately, our next position, which was before most of you were born, and just to show you how difficult chess is, this position, which looks totally wacky, the computer says is all zeros and equal. And black has two legal moves, and he played the wrong one. So chess is difficult. The right move is to take my knight. I take, of course. And then play bishop takes f2 check. If you can believe that. In fact, in this position, the engine says I should play king h1. And the idea is, if he takes my bishop, I take his bishop. And it says the white's winning. However, again, in a game of engine-manship, it says he should play bishop takes g2 check, and I guess it must see some perpetual here because it says this is all zeros. So that's beyond my capability as a human, but you can see how complicated it is. Okay, my opponent didn't play rook f7. He played king g8, which is the losing move, and sometimes the losing move turns into the winning move. It's unfortunate. Okay, and here, unlike every other move I've played in my life, I played the best move. I played by far the best move, and I'm guessing he overlooked it. Obviously, I could repeat and play for a draw by playing knight h6 double check, and this would be sort of a funny draw. And some of you are probably confused because you're thinking, what about this smothered mate? Why didn't Ben play smothered mate? Okay, good question. The reason I didn't play smothered mate is after queen g8, he doesn't have to take with a rook. He can take with a knight, and his rook is defending f7. So that would be bad. I mean, unless you had the black pieces, then it would be great. Okay, so after king g8, we looked at all these different variations where he should take my knight, and I could play knight h6 and play for a draw. But instead, I played queen f5. And this pins his bishop to his queen. It defends my f2 pawn, and it lines up my bishop with his king. And actually, I guess more important than any of that stuff, although I guess that all sounded important, was I'm attacking his bishop. Hooray. Okay. And the computer says that I'm incredibly winning here. Resignable kind of winning. Okay, so my opponent played the trickiest move, knight to d5, which blocks my bishop on b3. Now my knight on f7 actually is attacked because he blocked my bishop. And now I'm not on his bishop on c5 anymore. Okay, and now I got a little too confident. I thought everything won. And I was basically flipping a coin in my head. Should I take the knight on d5 with my rook or my bishop? And I was like, that wins, that wins, that wins, that wins. And because of that, I missed a very important defense from my opponent, which we saw in the last puzzle. This one's a little bit more complicated. If I play the move rook takes d5, today's engines say I'm plus 11. That's pretty good, plus 11. If he plays like the obvious move, let's say bishop takes d5, bishop takes d5 wins, queen takes d5 wins, so it doesn't really matter. But I guess I take with the bishop, that looks more threatening. And I knew that won, but I thought the way I played one more. So I was like, well, I'll play the better way. So I played bishop takes d5 because I'd rather win a piece than win two pieces for a rook. And my opponent played bishop takes d5, and I played queen takes d5. And I thought he would resign because I'm up a piece. I'm threatening the smothered mate that we looked at before with knight h6 check. And his bishop on c5 is hanging. So I have, I can move my knight anywhere. Knight d6 check wins his rook. I mean, basically I have all winning moves and I'm up a piece. I guess the obvious move is rook takes knight. I could take the bishop either way. I guess it doesn't matter. And I'm up a bishop for no pawns. So anyway, I thought this was an easy way to win, so I played this way. And after queen takes d5, it turns out black is winning. I hate when that happens, unless I'm black. Okay, so if you remember the last puzzle, it's basically the same idea, but it's a little bit trickier. My rook on d1 is defending against his back rank mate, and my rook is defending my queen. D5. And a lot of people, when I show them this position, they suggest bishop takes f2, and now they usually suggest rook takes knight, and now they run out of suggestions because white's just up a piece here, and white's winning. So it looks good, but it doesn't work. So what is the winning move here for black? Well, it's the same as the previous one. It's the old sugar me do, but it takes an extra move. It's rook e1 check here. My rook is defending my queen, but after the only legal move, rook takes e1, now my rook is not defending my queen. So he plays bishop takes f2 check. Now, what's funny is, if this was a random game, he's giving up a lot of pieces to win my queen, but the way it was set up beforehand, all my pieces are hanging and pinned and attacked. That's too bad. If somehow I wasn't losing any more material, I would actually be up material here. I would have a rook, a bishop, and a knight for a queen, but my knight on f7 is pinned and attacked twice, and it's defending my bishop on g5. So if it was black to move here, He could win both of my pieces by taking my knight with check, with rook takes f7, and then taking my bishop. Or he could take my bishop first, because my knight's pinned. So that's unfortunate. Okay, I unpinned with king g1. He played rook takes knight. And I saved my bishop. He got luffed, and this is completely losing. He has a queen and a pawn for rook and a bishop. My b pawn's weak. His king is perfectly safe. And I can't play bishop takes b4 because queen d4 check would pick up my bishop. It's unfortunate. So after h6, I resigned, losing a totally winning game to a trick that I know, although that game was played 25 years ago and then some, so maybe I didn't know it so well then. And I see it every now and then, this rook to the back rank check and the rook isn't defending the queen. Usually not in my games. It can happen in your game.